Hello students, welcome to grade 10th quadratic equations. Today we are going to do word problems based on quadratic equations. Type 1, problems based on numbers. The product of two consecutive positive integers is 306. Find the integers. Let the two consecutive integers be x and x plus 1. Because the gap between two consecutive integers is of 1, so we can always assume them to be x and x plus 1. You can also have x minus 1 and x. Now, according to the question, their product has to be 306. So on solving, I get a quadratic equation x square plus x is equal to 306, or x square plus x minus 306 is equal to 0. Here a is equal to 1, b is equal to 1, and c is equal to minus 306. Therefore, d will be equal to b square minus 4ac, which is equal to 1 square minus 4 into a 1 into minus 306. Please take care that when you have to take value of c, negative sign has to be taken along with it. Now this gives 1225. Now, by discriminant method, x is given by minus b plus minus under the root d upon 2a. For here, I require square root of d. So, I have found the square root of 1225 by this division method. Let us revise it quickly. First of all, we make pairs from left to right, right? And then we search for a number which is square, but it is near 12. It may be equal, it may be less. So 3 3s are 9, and now subtract it, you get 3 here. Then bring down this whole pair down. Now add 3 with 3, you get 6 here. And then you have to look for a such a number that can be written here also and here also, right? And then this number into this complete number should give me a number equal to this and or less than this, right? Now 5 into 65 will give me 325, and this gives me 0 here. So my square root of 1225 is 35. Now putting all these values here, I get minus 1 plus minus under the root 1225 upon 2 into 1, which is equal to minus 1 plus minus 35 upon 2. Now, what's the meaning of plus minus sign? It means once you have to solve by taking plus and once you have to solve by taking minus. Therefore, x is equal to minus 1 plus 35 upon 2, or x is equal to minus 1 minus 35 upon 2, which implies on solving x is equal to 17 or x is equal to minus 18. But you cannot take minus 18 as it has been given. The numbers are positive integers. So we discard this value. Hence our answer is going to be x is equal to 17 and x is equal to 18, because the next number is x plus 1. So 17 plus 1 is 18. Next question, divide 12 into two parts such that their product is 32. The two parts can be taken as x and 12 minus x. Now, according to the question, x into 12 minus x is equal to 32. This implies 12x minus x square is equal to 32. This implies x square minus 12x plus 32 is equal to 0, which implies x square minus 8x minus 4x plus 32 is equal to 0. I have used splitting the middle term method. Here I have split 12 minus 12 into two parts, minus 8 and minus 4, such that their sum gives me minus 12 and their product gives me 32. Now from here, x into x minus 8 minus 4 into x minus 8 is equal to 0, which implies x minus 8 into x minus 4 is equal to 0. Implies x minus 8 is equal to 0, or x minus 4 is equal to 0, which implies x is equal to 8, or x is equal to 4. Now if x is equal to 8, then what will I get here? 12 minus x will give me 12 minus 8, which is equal to 4. And if x is equal to 4, then 12 minus x will give me 12 minus 4 is equal to 8. Hence, the two parts are 8 and 4 respectively. Question number 3. Divide 12 into 2 parts such that the sum of their squares is 74. Let the two parts of 12 be taken as x and 12 minus x. Then, according to the question, x square plus 12 minus x whole square is equal to 74. This implies x square plus 12 square plus x square minus 2 into 12 into x is equal to 74. Remember, here I am applying the identity a minus b whole square, and it has 3 terms: a square plus b square minus 2ab. Now this implies x square plus x square, that is equal to 2x square, 144 minus 24x minus 74 is equal to 0. Again solving, I get 2x square minus 24x plus 70 is equal to 0. I notice that 2 is the common factor of all these terms, so I divide by 2 and I get x square minus 12x plus 35 is equal to 0. Now break minus 12 into 2 parts such that product is 35 but the sum is minus 12. So I have two numbers, 7 and 5, such that I can take minus 7 plus minus 5, which gives me minus 12, and minus 7 into minus 5 gives me 35. So I have broken like this: x square minus 7x minus 5x plus 35 is equal to 0. This implies x into x minus 7 minus 5 into x minus 7 is equal to 0, which implies x minus 7 into x minus 5 is equal to 0. Implies x minus 7 is equal to 0 or x minus 5 is equal to 0, which implies x is equal to 7 or x is equal to 5. Now we cannot stop here. We have to solve it further by taking each of the values separately. If the value of x is 7, what will be the other part? The other part is going to be 12 minus x, that is 12 minus 7 is equal to 5. And if x is equal to 5, then what will be the other part? 12 minus x is equal to 12 minus 5 is equal to 7. Hence, the two required parts of 12 are 5 and 7. And you can verify also, square of 5 you have to take such that sum of their squares is 74. Let's check it. Square of 5 is 25 and square of 7 is 49. 49 plus 25 is equal to 74. So hence our answer is correct. Problem number 4. The sum of two natural numbers is 8. And the sum of their reciprocals is 8 upon 15. Find the numbers. The numbers can be taken as x and 8 minus x. According to the question, 1 upon x plus 1 upon 8 minus x is equal to 8 upon 15. Butterfly method, 8 minus x plus x upon x into 8 minus x is equal to 8 upon 15. This implies 8 minus x plus x upon 8x minus x squared is equal to 8 upon 15. X and x cancel. Cross multiply. 8 into 15 is equal to 8 into 8x minus x squared. This implies x squared minus 8x plus 15 is equal to 0. I have brought both these terms on this side. That is why x square minus 8x plus 15 is equal to 0. This implies x square minus 5x minus 3x plus 15 is equal to 0. which implies x into x minus 5 minus 3 into x minus 5 is equal to 0, implies x minus 5 into x minus 3 is equal to 0. This implies x minus 5 is equal to 0 or x minus 3 is equal to 0. Implies x is equal to 5 or x is equal to 3. Now taking them separately. If x is equal to 3, 8 minus x will be 3. If x is equal to 3, then 8 minus x will be equal to 5. Hence the two numbers are 3 and 5. Thank you.